Hey, what's up, guys? Undead Vamp here. We got a bunch of exciting stuff to show you today. I've made a huge amount of base improvements and such. So first off, let's look at this guy. So in the last episode, I planted this guy and I was looking for a better way to make fertilizer. And well, I found it. So these Nuka... it's got water. So these Nukalizers right here. Highly nuclear fertilizer that's 4 times more effective than normal brand fertilizer. These are actually extremely easy to make. So I got 14 of these guys. Zeth gave me 2 of them. I made 12 myself. And then I got some of these guys in here that I'm just using to irrigate this. I'm actually pretty sure that these waters use themselves. Because, it was already missing one. So I just got those guys in there. So... Alright, let's collect up these black pearls. So, I meant to record it. I tried to record it. I didn't record it. I meant to, but I didn't. Sorry. But, check this out. Check this out, alright? Right here we got a bionic dragon. 4,500 metal. 500 electronics. 250 polymer. 250 metal. That's raw metal. And... 150 black pearls, but I actually already made one, and this thing is friggin' massive. Look at this thing, it's crazy huge. Here, let me gamma up a little bit. Oh, and let me get rid of that bloom as well. Like, look at this thing. That stego is like a little baby compared to this, and it does a stupid amount of damage, way more than my Mystic Pterodon. Check this out. Look at that. That's from the breath attack. It almost does 1 million damage just from the breath attack. Thing is insane. Alright, let me try to bite something. I'll show you how much it does when you're chewing on stuff. Let's see. We got a little dodo right here. Oh, that's weird. It actually... So the last time I did that, it did actually more. Let's see. Now look at these stats. Just crazy stats. And I could kill almost anything by just breathing fire on it. Look at that. That was a Mystic Academy Carno Berserker right there, and it just one-shotted it. Like, it was nothing. Let's look at this little king. What was this thing called? A Fluffy? Something like that? Oh, I missed. The only complaint I have with this is you can't upgrade the movement speed, and the turn radius is absolutely terrible. Alright, where's that Fluffy at? Come here, Fluffy. Oh, it was a Whiskers, that's what it's called. Yeah, look at this, just crazy damage, just killing everything. Alright, there was actually a... Yeah, Anki right here. I just want to see what level this guy is. 400 Anki Berserker. I'm actually kind of curious about this guy, I'm going to tame him up. Oh, he took a lot of hits. Was that my fault? Did I do that? Yeah, he's got really... bad health right now. Let me go ahead and throw some... I don't have any berries on me. Here, let's go ahead and reload this guy. Let me go ahead and pick up some berries real quick. I'll see how quickly this guy tames up. So yeah, we got plenty of black pearls now. Those are growing like crazy. I made some teleporter pads, which I'll show you in a minute. I got one going to Zeth's base. I got one going to, Star Wars stuffs. Death Star. So I got one going to Snow for penguins. It's like a penguin-only spawn area type of thing. And then one going to Zeth's base, and then one going to the volcano for metal. So let's tame this guy up real quick. See how long is this going to take. Ooh, this could take a while, actually. Might even need some more berries. It says the taming effectiveness is 99.7. So it should be alright. Alright, we're gonna let this guy tame up, and we'll be right back. Alright guys, we're back. This guy's pretty much tamed up. Let's give him a couple seconds here. There he is. Spranky. My super clever name for him. Alright, let's throw on this saddle that he had. Ooh. Hold on, let's take a look at these skins real quick. Oh, wow, that is... I'm just kind of floating on a saddle, look at that. Oh, I don't want those spikes in my butt, so I guess that makes sense. Okay, let's see what these different costumes look like. Yeah, that one's kind of bland. What's that one called? The green? Alright, let's try the blue tech. Oh, that one's cool. I can already guarantee that's going to be my one. Let's put that aside. Let's see, what is this? The red tech? Is that what that is? The tento berries is in the way. I think that says red tech. So that's pretty cool. I like the blue better, though. Then we got something, something, some kind of pink. And a green tech. That's pretty cool. And we got a purple. And a... what is this? Sky blue. Yeah, definitely gonna have to stick with that blue tech. Where's that at? Blue tech armor Anki. We're just gonna go ahead and drop all these things. Yeah, definitely the coolest one out of the bunch. Let's see, what's the statistics on this guy? So we got 1.2 million HPs, that's a good amount. Good amount of stamina. It's not a lot of weight, definitely gonna use more weight. Maybe some more melee damage. Just gonna need more food as well. Let's go harvest up some food with him real quick. Go ahead and K out a little bit. Yeah, so that dragon though, he's insane. And while I was waiting for the Anki to tame up, I realized he actually has a really, really cool ability that most flyers don't have. And I'll show you that here in a second. There you go, plenty of berries there. A few levels as well. Let's pump that weight a little bit. Fortunately, I can't pick him up with the dragon. That'd be really cool. So we're gonna leave that guy there for now, but let me show you what this guy can do. Are you ready for it? You ready? Do you know what's coming yet? Here it goes. Yep, that's right. He can fly in the water. He also tramples things. I don't know if you noticed that just now. Boom. Look at that. And he can breathe fire underwater too. And just kill crazy amounts of stuff under here. Look at that screen spam. Look at all that. It's crazy. I've already leveled this guy up quite a bit just by doing what I'm doing now. I will like fly on the beach and I'll see a whole bunch of dodos and dodos, and I'll just unleash the fire on them. Like half the time I don't even see them down there on the beach. See like all that? Like look at all those kills. I didn't even see half those things. Like look at all that. It's just insane. Kills, just all the kills. Super cool. Oh, the screen spam is real though. Alright, where's our Anki at? Alright guys, I'm going to take this guy back to base, and I'll show you some of the other things that I have as well. Alright guys, we're back. Okay, so I used my teleporter to get on top of the volcano. I just want to see exactly how much metal this is going to give us, and if it's even worth using or keeping. Oh, that's actually not bad. That's not bad at all. That's more than what I'm getting. I'm just using my pickaxe, and I have a... See, I have a apprentice pickaxe. It's not the best, but this Anki's definitely the better bet. I leveled him up a little bit. I used, I just pumped the weight with him. Right now, the biggest issue is going to be the weight, because he doesn't get very much per level. And I've already put probably 10 levels into it, and his weight's only at 4,500 right now. But yeah, once I get that up there, this guy's gonna be a decent little guy to get metal. Yeah, not too terrible. Just pump some more weight. Definitely gonna have to find a better alternative to getting metal than this guy, though. There's gotta be a better way. But metal's not too big of an issue right now anyway. Alright, let's bring this guy back. Get that teleporter lag right there. Yeah, this guy's super slow too. I'm just gonna leave him here for now. There you go. Alright, so a couple other things I've done. So I made tons of gas for the generator to be able to keep it running. I went and got some organic polymer and turned it into normal polymer. So a whole bunch of that right here. Here's that nucleizer. It's 100 narcotics, 75 thatch, and 1 blood pack, which is why I have a blood extraction syringe in there. Let's see what else we got in here. I'm not sure why that egg is in there. We'll move that. Yeah, so I still got plenty of metal saved up. And then if we come up here to the top of the base, I got all this fancy stuff. Oop. So I got this guy, the fusion reactor that you load these cells into. And I actually logged off and I left this in here for probably almost 24 hours, and it only used up 8 cells, so this is gonna last a good amount of time. And if I remember right, it wasn't too expensive. Now if I hop up here, I got this ceiling mounted turret that I have guarding the front with a bunch of ammo in there. So I haven't actually got to test this out yet, so I'm going to grab, let's see if I can lure something over. Whistle passive real quick. Just come a little closer and whistle passive. Make sure these guys get the message. Alright, so let's try to hit something and aggro it over there. See how much damage this thing does. I'll take that. Give me it. Is that Pteranodon egg or is that Mystic? Okay, it's just a Pteranodon egg. Alright, so we're going to lure this guy. It's set to only kill wild. And I just want to see how much damage it does. Because I made tons of ammo for it. It took me a while to grind out all that ammo. Alright, come on, buddy. Maybe I need to increase the range a little bit on it. Oh, there you go. Okay, so it's not a whole lot of damage. Okay, it's not... It was only level 200 Dillo. I'd hate to see, like, if a Mystic T-Rex or something came up. And that guy's not going to do very well. But maybe I'll place some more up top. Like, maybe across the entire ceiling. Try that out. But for now, that'll have to do. So I was looking at some of these gods. And this guy takes 20,000 metal. But one of these days, we're definitely going to build a god of the island. Because I want to see how huge it is. Because if this guy is only considered a boss, and he's bigger than my entire base, I'd love to see how huge one of the gods is. But alright, let's see what else is on the agenda for today. So, I would like to get a better Anki. Let me get on Tobinator. Come on, Tobinator. Come on down. Come on, buddy. He doesn't want to listen. I need to spank him. Come on, Tobinator. Looks like he's stuck on that wall. Tobinator, useless. Okay, so what I tried to do here, you see these metal ladders? I'm assuming you do, because they're really obvious and not hidden at all. I tried to take these off, disassemble them, whatever, pick them up, and I can't do it. They're stuck inside, and I can't even use them. So they're just going to be there for a little while until I decide to expand the base. And I think the same thing happened back here, except I was actually able to remove the ladders. Almost forgot about this hidden door we got here. So, I know that's there. Trust me, I'm not blind. I see it. It's just going to have to stay. And the whole reason I did that was to be able to access the inventory on the turret. But what I didn't realize was you can actually just climb on top of it and access it from the top of the ceiling. And I didn't know that beforehand, so... Come on, buddy. Okay, so yeah, let me show you some of these other teleporters. So, here, this is the one to the volcano that you already saw with the Anki. Then we got the snow one, and I found this really cool, club. Where'd that club go? Let me find that club real quick. I think I put it in my old equipment. Oh, that's not where I wanted to go. Oh, jeez. Yeah, let's go up and over. You're a bird. You're meant to go up and over. Okay. Let's run inside of here. So it is in this crate. Yeah, so I found this Ascendant Wooden Club. Which, as you guys probably already know, Ascendant is the best out of all the tiers. So I was pretty excited about that. And I haven't actually used it to get polymer yet. I used it on a couple other things to see if I can, you know, how well it knocks out stuff. So, I'm going to use it to go to the snow. And I'm going to take out some of these penguins, see how much polymer that I get out of them. Oh, you know what? I should have took a bird with me anyway. Yeah, there's a Spino right there. Yeah, let me go back and get a bird. I don't know if they optimize these teleporters more, but I remember there being a lot more lag than there is. Oh, there it is. There's the famous lag. Alright, let's take one of these guys. Alright, so right off the bat, let's find some of these penguins. Take out some of these dudes. So we got three of them down. And switch to our Ascendant Club. Alright, so it looks like we get about 250 per penguin that we kill. Yeah, 248 seems to be the number. Is there another penguin laying around? I thought I killed three. Maybe I only killed two. Yeah, I guess I only killed two. Oh, no, there it is. Yep, 248 is the number. So 248 per penguin. That's not terrible at all. How much do I get if I just harvest my bird, I wonder? Did I get anything for that? Oh, my bird is full of stuff, I think. Let's drop a ton of this meat and all this useless garbo. Get out of here, get out of here, get out of here. Alright, let's try that again. That was a waste of a penguin. There no more penguins? There's gotta be more penguins. There's a penguin. And I missed. And I missed. Okay. Oh, I killed more than one. Okay, that was 144, but I don't know if that was both penguins that I just killed. Yeah, I think that was a two. But either way, you can see that I get a lot less than when I use the club, so the club is definitely the best bet here. Let's kill this derpy Spino. I don't know what he's doing. Little level 20 guy. Yeah, so we'll take this organic polymer, make some actual polymer out of it, just so it doesn't spoil. Up a little bit of melee on this guy. Yeah. Happy dance, happy dance. Alright, we'll come over here. Put that club away. And let's go ahead and throw some of that fiber in there because we're going to need it. We'll throw that in there as well. And then we'll throw this organic polymer in there. start crafting up the actual polymer. Let's take the polymer off this guy as well. Throw it in here. There, I've crafted all that stuff up. Yeah, I already have a crazy amount of polymer. I don't even know what I'm going to do with all that polymer. So I think what we'll do is we'll look into some of these other things inside of here. Because there's all kinds of crazy stuff in here. So, plasma canister is used in weapons. So, do I have weapons that I can... Wait, what is this Mach 5 armor? It doesn't actually seem... This doesn't seem that good. No, it's not even close to the level of my steel items. So we'll leave that be for now. Let's see, what is RFC? Okay, it's a bunch of building stuff. Yeah, some like heavy base, concrete base type things. We got some lights, we got some defenses. Oh, we can make a little pillbox. That's cool. A little bunker. Oh, and you can actually attach the shutters and the door. That's actually really awesome. We got some mines as well. Incendiary. Incendiary. I'm pretty sure there's supposed to be a D in there. Incendiary. But okay, incendiary mines. Toxic mines and some high explosive mines. And we got a whole bunch of turrets in here. We got the Inferno turret. So that fires incendiary shells, and flamethrower is a steady flame. AMT-3, effective long to mid-range missile turret, best used outside and not on platforms. It's weird that it specifically says not on platforms. Then there's the ground version of the one that I have. There's the ceiling version right there. Plasma turret, a large turret that fires unstable plasma particles at long range. So that's actually really cool. I'm assuming you're supposed to mount this one, though. And that you can't just have it automated. And then there's a turret status screen. So for crafting, we got... Okay, we've already made all those things. I might make more grow tanks later on. We got all the different power cables. We got these mechs. So we have a hail turret. Tail turret. That you place on the HST, which is this guy, the little battle mech right here. That takes a ridiculous amount of supplies. And then this guy, the harvester. I actually looked into the harvester outside of recording, and the harvester isn't nearly as good as like Mystic Dinos when it comes to actually harvesting stuff. I am curious about this little drone guy though. Ranged attack drone. Maybe we'll make one of these guys up. I have to make another fusion reactor, though. So what does that take me? More cemented paste, polymer electronics. I don't know. How many electronics do I have? We might save that for later. Let me look into... If I have a lot of electronics, I'll go ahead and make some. But if not, I'm going to have to wait on it. Okay, I have the pearls to make more, though. So that's something. So we'll turn this on. Go ahead and... Okay, yeah, we can make some of this stuff. Alright. Alright, guys, we'll be back after those... After these electronics crapped up. So, here's. Alright, guys, we are back. We got all those electronics made up. Pop those guys in here. Alright. What were we even looking at? I got really distracted on leveling up my... Dragon? Oh, that's right, we're gonna make this guy. So, polymer, fusion reactor. That's right, we need to make a fusion reactor real quick. Crafting, fusion reactor, cementing base, and polymer. We have plenty of polymer. I think we have a good amount of cementing base. Well, first off, let me show you the statistics of this guy. I got him up a crazy amount with, let's see, 2 million melee damage and 23 million HP. Check this thing out. Breath attack does almost 2 million damage. And the bite attack. Okay, nope, that's bull. That's bull. Hold on. Nope, still bull. There it is. 6 million damage. On something that's not, you know, crazy or from a mod pack. It does 6 million damage. What do you want, Mantis? Oh, I should have tamed that guy. He's level 600. Yeah, this guy is absolutely insane now. I thought he was good before. It's nothing compared to how he is now. Awesome. Alright. Anyway. Polymer and cementing paste. So, let's pop in here. There's cementing paste. Plenty of it. Need to eat some foods real quick. And some polymer. I know I have a crap ton in here. Let's grab all that. Oh, we're getting a little bit of frame drops there. Alright. Let's go ahead and put all this in there. So under crafting, we now have the fusion reactor. Make one of those guys up. And then... see, what were we looking at again? Man, I keep forgetting. Is it? That's right, unmanned mech. We're looking at this guy, the drone. Let's craft that guy up real quick. There he is. And we'll put him there. Alright, let's see what this thing's all about. Let's gamma up a little bit so you can see. Oh. Alright, so, sentry drone, RX-4 sentry drone, don't really, okay, you can follow me, I'm assuming I gotta put bullets in him. Can I put these bullets in him? Let's just grab 100 rounds of that. Ah, everything's going crazy. Alright. So I'm assuming that works because he took it. Let's see. I'm assuming he works. Aggression to aggressive. Alright, follow me, buddy. Ooh, he's pretty quick. Alright, let's see him. Gonna kill this dodo over here? This guy? Yeah, okay, cool. So he does accept that ammo. Oh, he doesn't use any ammo. Free bullets? Alright, come on, bud. What about this mantis over here? Oh, that's right, they jumped. Oh, hey, buddy. Where's my guy? Take him out, guy. Oh no, he's hurting my machine. Oh. You alright, buddy? Ooh, okay, I can damage my own machine. That's good to know. Probably should have tested that with something other than a lightsaber. Alright, cool. So we'll set him to neutral then. So let's tame this guy up real quick. Yeah, we'll just have this guy sitting outside of our base. Be a cool little prop. Oh, come on now. I'm just gonna have to... Alright, let me just chop this rock down. Okay, that made it worse. can't access his inventory. Oh well, we'll get a new one. That's fine. Oh, he gave us polymer, that's cool. Anyway guys, that's gonna be it for today. We made this cool little sentry drone. I leveled up my huge, enormous, oversized dragon, who's absolutely ridiculous and does 6 million damage. The only thing that sucks about this guy, though, is I can't upgrade his movement speed. It's so frustrating. Let's get some HP on that guy. Alright, anyway, guys. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, thumbs up. All that good stuff. Do what you gotta do. If you didn't like it, hit the thumbs down. But then at least give me the courtesy of giving me a comment on why, so I can help improve myself. Anyway, guys, have a nice day.